The Deschutes Land Trust conserves and cares for the lands and water that sustain Central Oregon. Our protected lands help wildlife thrive, they help clean our air and water, and they help us fight against climate change. Some of the lands we've conserved are in great condition and just require our protection, while other places need help to recover so they can provide homes for wildlife, they can clean our air and water, and absorb carbon from the atmosphere. That's where restoration comes in. Some of our conserved lands require forest restoration because the trees are overcrowded and unhealthy. In these areas, we'll go in and do thinning, either mechanically, where we remove selected trees using large machinery, or by hand, where we cut small trees using chainsaws, then build piles and come back and burn the piles later when the conditions are safe to do so. Regardless of the method, our end goal is the same, to create a more diverse forest that includes openings where light can penetrate and promote the growth of healthy vegetation, and denser areas where wildlife can find shelter. This diversity of structure is great for both the plants and the animals, and it also helps protect our neighbors from the spread of catastrophic wildfire. On other properties, our focus is on restoring meadows that have been invaded by weeds. We're working hard to battle the weeds and bring back robust, diverse native plant communities. This is especially important work for our struggling pollinators. Think bees, monarchs, and birds. How we wage the battle depends on lots of factors, like what types of weeds they are, where they're located, and what the terrain is like. In some situations, we rely heavily on our amazing weed warrior volunteers to pull the weeds by hand. In other areas, like at Camp Polk Meadow Preserve, we spread huge sheets of plastic out on the ground after we've cleared it. Then the sun cooks the soil all summer long, and the heat that builds up under the plastic kills the weed seeds. Then we remove the plastic and plant the area with lots of native grasses and wildflowers. The Land Trust conserved lands along Wychoose Creek provide a great example of where we focused our attention on stream restoration. About half of Wychoose Creek's 40 miles were straightened in the mid-1900s, and since then, the creek has eroded so far down in many areas that it can no longer connect with its surrounding meadows. In our high desert region, these streamside meadows are rare and critically important places. Sometimes we use heavy equipment to adjust elevations, construct pools, channel networks, and other important habitat features. Other times we take a lighter approach and follow the beaver's lead by hand building mini dam-like structures that help slow water flow and create side channels. Either way, we're able to provide the space needed for nature to reclaim her natural processes, for water to spread out and soak in, for fish and wildlife to thrive, and for our local communities to engage and participate in this important work. Healthier natural systems mean healthier communities for all of us. We rely on our forests, our meadows, and our streams for the air we breathe, for the water we drink, and for inspiration and rejuvenation. And we need healthy systems that can adapt to our changing climate, now and far into the future.